and good morning to all of you. And I'm certainly honored to be kicking off the 15th Digital Summit for shop.org. So as everyone here certainly knows, our industry is in the midst of dynamic change, and it has been. And it's been fueled by the digital economy and certainly shifts in consumer behavior. But I think this evolution provides a unique opportunity for all retailers to be part of what we at HSNI have coined the term of the new landscape of boundaryless retail, which is a world devoid of artificial barriers driven by innovation and collaboration, where we leverage the power of technology to create a seamless experience for consumers. So over the course of my career, I've certainly learned that if you're not willing to disrupt yourself, ultimately you're going to get disrupted. So we need to stay intellectually curious. We need to keep the customer at the center of our strategy while we discover relevant ways to engage with her right where she is. So as members of the digital community, we've certainly witnessed how new technologies are tearing through the traditional walls of retail. So it was only a few years ago when I was here at the Digital Summit and we were talking excitedly about the virtues of multi-channel retailing. And then it quickly seemed to shift to omni-channel retailing. But in today's environment, it truly is all about distributed commerce. And described most simply, it's a strategy that allows consumers to purchase anything, anywhere, at any time. So at HSNI, we certainly embrace boundaryless retail, where we leverage innovation, technology, and content to create a 360-degree experience for the customer to build communities and drive commerce. And we're very excited about the opportunities that distributed commerce allow us. And this is just an example of how we look at our solar system of being able to reach the consumer. But it allows shoppers to engage in a way that is platform agnostic and audience centric. So we're not clinging to any particular method or channel for sales. So instead, we're looking to expand our audience base and go where the customers are. And they're increasingly choosing to transact through our digital channels, our mobile channels, and it's a way for them to interact with our brands. And it's everything that's keeping everyone in this room pretty busy. So today, at HSNI, over half our sales are now through a digital platform. Over 20% of our sales are through a mobile platform, and that's only going to accelerate. So as a direct-to-consumer retail for over 40 years, we're actually now expanding into physical experiences with a number of our brands to create destinations that are differentiated and unique. So we see it as the era of convergence that Matt was describing, where online, bricks and mortar, and social come together like never before. So I want to quickly share some of the strategies we're implementing across HSNI to reach the next level of growth. But what you'll see is that there is no one strategy. Each one is customized to the customer and to the brand. But what is consistent is they all provide an opportunity to create new ways of customer acquisition, to deepen engagement, and to create unique experiences and to broaden the reach for our brands. So we opened our first Ballard Design Studio store last year in King of Prussia, and recently opened our second in Tyson's Corner right out of Washington, D.C. So as other brands are shrinking their retail footprints, we're investing in this new area of experiential retail growth where we have the data and we have the customer knowledge to drive our own traffic in key markets and expand the consumer touch point for our brand. It's a very experiential retail destination and it brings service and customization to a new level in a modern environment that inspires consumers to become their own decorator and designer. We offer them a similar opportunity for personalization, both in-store and online. So as you see here, customers can customize a design by selecting their fabric, finishing touches, detail for their space. So imagine over 1,000 different ways to customize a Louis XIV chair. So we also recently launched an augmented reality design solution for our Ballard and Frontgate customers. Leveraging the capabilities of a personal mobile device and an installed app, users are able to virtually place desired objects in their own homes and engage with more than 1,000 pieces of home decor and furniture. So it's a very easy to use app. It utilizes the device's camera to scan the room and then overlays the product in a realistic 3D immersive experience, showing the size, color, and aesthetic of the furniture in that specific room. Our Garnet Hill brand has created an innovative, transportable boutique made from an old shipping container. So it's a pop-up boutique which offers customers an opportunity to physically engage with our product assortment through an immersive brand experience outfitted with digital terminals for easy checkout. We just relocated from New Hampshire to the South Street Seaport in New York. It's part event space, part marketing, part commerce, and creates local communities, which are so key to the Garnet Hill brand. Our Grandin Road brand, until now only available in our catalog and online, especially for all our Halloween decor product, debuted its first ever interactive retail haunted house concept store at Macy's in Herald Square, complete with magic, mystical accessories, and elegant decor. So the seasonal pop-up is really designed to inspire, engage, interact, and entertain through the months of September all the way to Halloween. So this collaboration is a great opportunity to drive brand awareness for Grandin Road and traffic for Macy's. So yes, we believe in transformational collaborations, even with other retailers, where together we are even more powerful and can create a greater experience and customer acquisition. And finally, at HSN, our 24/7 channel, our media platform, our digital platforms, and extensive video content offer a unique opportunity to deliver immersive storytelling, personalities, proprietary products, and emotional engagement through a comprehensive 360-degree experience. So one recent example of this was the launch of Grammy Award winner Michael Bublé's first ever fragrance, By Invitation. So its exclusive cross-platform launch concluded live appearances on HSN, seamless digital execution, tapped into his nearly 15 million passionate fans through a well-orchestrated social strategy. And we were able to sell out of more than 21,000 units in less than 24 hours. So through an expanded strategic partnership with Facebook, we're investing in data, personalization, and customization to target custom audiences using posts and live streams, creating experiences and content to inspire commerce. And of course, we're leveraging other social platforms as well, whether it be Twitter, Instagram, or Snapchat. But our most recent example of boundaryless retail, which is a full 360-degree experience leveraging technology to create an even more immersive relationship with the customer, was our partnership with Serena Williams to debut her fall signature statement collection during New York Fashion Week. The event streamed across all our digital platforms, as well as Vogue.com and People.com. But every stream was technology enabled to shop directly into the video stream. And we also offered HSN mobile app users front row access to this exclusive event through a special virtual reality 360-degree live stream where you actually felt like you were part of the show. And for the first time, we also streamed the broadcast on our live television network with stylists then speaking how to get the look in real time. So take a quick look at the experience.
I dreamt of being in New York Fashion Week all my life. You know, having this opportunity again is great. I saw her walk upright and tall. When she moves, everyone watches.
I get you dancing to the dicky 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 dog. This is my town. right there. It extends to the HSN runway because all of the looks are available for you tonight.
I was really inspired after Wimbledon and during the Olympics just on the strength of women.
Wow, that was an incredible signature statement, and we get to take a piece of that home with the incredible collection you just saw.
So this was a great example of distributed commerce and our unique ability to blend entertainment with that commerce, so leveraging the assets that we have. So it's innovative ideas like this that help to generate consumer awareness and ultimately drive growth. And everything I just showed you all happened just within the last 2 weeks. So as you can see, there's absolutely no one size fits all. And I think as retailers in the digital economy, we have to create unique experiences. We have to capitalize on our personal differentiators and challenge ourselves to think platform agnostic and audience centric. So I was recently appointed to the US Department of Commerce Digital Economy Board of Advisors. So the board grapples with a lot of the issues we're talking here this week. Innovation, privacy and security, attracting and retaining talent, the role of social media, and so many other topics that fuel the digital economy of today, but prepare us for tomorrow's retail landscape. So the collaboration and exchange of diverse ideas and thoughts that will occur amongst this community, it's never been more important. And certainly this summit brings together the best minds for learning, networking, sharing, collaborating. So I would say take advantage of this time and the mindshare of your industry colleagues, because together we will shape the future of retail. Have a wonderful time, and thank you.